the third annual Flag Day 225, and already off the jump, a big move on the outside lane as Jonathan Lawrence sleeping a little bit there on that restart. Trek to make sure the restart's good. Tower says yes. That's how it will work through lap number one. Out in front leading lap number one. As Jonathan Lawrence now moving right up to the back bumper of that number 13 machine. Jonathan Lawrence, an emotional victory on opening night here at Ace Speedway, and they're gonna go side by side, door to door, for the race lead. Couple of 13s trying to draw a beat on that number set, 66 there on the bottom side of the racetrack as they work into three and four. And trying to keep it on the outside. You can hear the tires squealing from up here in the booth with these limits. And are they going to go three wide? Yes, they are. Three wide. Oh, they thought about it. As I believe that back 13 thought, well, you know what? Might be a good idea if we don't make that happen. But still a big run out here. Three cars, but they are racing like they are the only ones out there. It's Jonathan Lawrence now going to get ahead by about a car. Some official timing and scoring to work its way through the circle. And there you see the pass for second. And you see that 13 machine that was oh so strong at the beginning. Started to struggle here a little bit. Got a great restart. They lost in here these last couple of laps. Get only 15 laps here to compete for. As we will get mini stock rolling just after this. So a reminder down there in the pits, mini stock. Make sure you are getting ready and ready to go. Lined up on the grid as soon as it's free. So, looking like we're going to have a battle up front here in not too much time as Lawrence starting to lose a little bit of ground. Halfway point this time. Looking like a two-horse race up here at the front of the field and nearly contact into three and four. And here they go, side by side, right at the line, halfway through this one. As you're gonna see a pass for the lead for just a moment. Here comes Luke Travis. Up the inside, Luke Travis clear to the front, and you can hear the family in the stands. They are happy, waving them on. Luke Travis to the lead. Jonathan Lawrence will take another shot at him, though. They're one and two. A car length separates them, and now Travis starting to make up a little bit of ground. Lawrence hanging on as much as he can, but Travis proving to be too much for him at the moment. Six laps to go. The tires squealing hard as they work through three and four. See the hand in the air from the flagman. Brandon Willard, five laps to go here at the famous 4/10 mile. Not a long battle. Travis has done a tremendous job working his way slowly through the field, being there at the perfect time when he needs to be there. Starting to pull away here by a couple of car lengths. Continuing to stretch that lead out. Family's cheering him on. Lawrence trying to mount a charge. Looks like he got a little bit of a better run through one and two, and now may have something to say through three and four. This is becoming a battle, folks. White flag in the air. Can Travis hang on for one more lap, or can Lawrence try to make a charge up? Off of turn two for the final time. It's looking like Travis gonna easily have this one in the bag. Off to turn number four, checker flag in the air. Luke Travis, your winner here in Extreme.
Feels pretty good. Thank all these fans coming out every week to support this track. I know it's hard to get out to the track, so our fuel prices, but got to thank everybody coming out here. Tucker, Sunside, and Windows, Grassroots, just my whole family.
Whole family's out here supporting the effort here from Mike and Tucker. The winner here tonight at home in second.
You had a chance in that final restart. You got a great jump off of the turn three. Had a run in turn one. Kind of takes through that last and a half or so.
Yeah, we had a good chance for that last caution to get back to him, and we knew coming here that he'd be the car to beat, obviously. And I turned up under pretty good on that last restart, and I went down there and I hit that speedy dry at the bottom, and it jumped out of me, and he was already gassed back up, and he was gone by the time I held back onto it. But I mean, if anybody deserves it, it's him. I mean, he's figured this place out, so congratulations to him.
All right, bringing him home in second tonight, Tyler Bliss, a solid run, 12 driver number 18. Look to be solid up front, but what's kind of going through your mind? You get that late restart out of nowhere. You think you had a shot to win this thing?
I don't know. If the two guys in front of me got together or whatever, which I don't want that to happen on anybody, but if they got together, it's a possibility. I mean, all three of us, pretty even. Tucker's maybe about a tenth better than me and Tyler. Me and Tyler's pretty much about tit for tat. Just lost a little bit of track position there, and don't really know exactly what to do to adjust on the car. I think Greg with Greg Butcher Trucking, Jimmy and Teresa with J&T Services, Adam with John Baker Plumbing, and David and Blaine for coming out to help me, and thanks for all the vets for showing up tonight.
Absolutely. Want to thank all the vets for coming out tonight. A good battle between third place Chuck Wall and second place Tyler Bliss. Well, next up, folks, we got 50 laps to lead model stocks followed by fireworks show. Lord and Lord, your top two here for 50 laps. Jason, I'd say for not being sure that you were going to run about 24 hours ago, that was a pretty solid run out there.
Yeah, I'm glad Robert Turner talked me into coming. We had an awesome car. Not bad. The crew, we didn't sign. We was coming to last night, and like I said, we ain't touched the car since Franklin County, and this thing was a mess. So we spent all day, my whole crew on it, and I'm working pretty hard and out here in the sun and stuff. We hit it. We hit it good night.
You sure did. Well, you got another 50 laps to look forward to a little bit later. Think you can hit it just as well in that?
Yeah, I think so. I'm still fighting a little. I'm hitting the ground just a little bit, going in the turn right about the center, and I'm fighting that. I'm going to stick up a little bit on the front end. But, I think so. We got a good car.
All right, Jason, you are confident that maybe he can do it here for a second time.
Yeah.
As we'll run the 2050 just a little bit later on tonight. Move up in a second spot, but looking forward to the next 2050. What do you think he can adjust on this thing to make it a little bit better for another 50 laps?
Well, the car was pretty close. They're making a few little changes. The restart there did Jason a favor. He got away, and I was battling hard with Trevor. So we had just as good of a car, and I just needed a shot at him. And you get out front like that, it's hard to make it up. And then you think in the back of your mind, well, I got another race, so I don't want to burn my tires up trying to get to it. We had a good piece. We'll tweak on it. We'll get even better. We'll run this second. I thank my guys for all the work. Brian Trailers, Brian's Automotive, Sellers Racing, Rich Sellers.
All right, well, Dustin, we wish you the best of luck here. Coming up for 50 more laps, Dustin Rumley brings her home in second tonight. And with the Trent Cruz, I will say this car looked to be a lot better as we started getting to them towards the end of that race. You think you may have something to say for these guys up front here in the second lap?
Yeah, the guys work hard, and we saved a little bit at the beginning, and it seemed to come our way after that caution. So hopefully we get a little bit better and give them a run for the money the second race. But I wouldn't be here without this great opportunity that R&S and Trey Dillard and Steve Stallings gave me. So I'd like to thank them for letting me be here. And solid ground, electrical, Southside Disposal, Go to Works, Elite Recycling, all the guys, hard work. They come here early this morning. We worked hard all day. We got the car good. We just need to be better.
All right, well, the one thing I'm getting is a little bit of adjustments out of each of our top three winners, Jason York, Dustin Rumley, and Trent Cruz, looking to make a couple of improvements.
Modifieds, 35 laps.
Thank you.
practice. We was a loose in practice. Everybody was a little, some of them was tight, some of them was loose. We weren't on, we had time to work on this car because we hadn't been racing all that much, and we found some things wrong with it. We got it dialed in. This thing was on the rail, but it was playing board performance, helping me on the setup, narrow pole engines, and Bixby coffee. Y'all go get you some of that Bixby coffee. That's the Republican place to get you some Bixby coffee. Sticking in there, man, keeping this thing going. All the people that help him, including y'all, really give us a good family place to have a good race. And I'd like to thank everybody for coming out. Appreciate everybody coming out tonight. And this job is good. I love
it. Yeah, you know, this car's been that way ever since we've had it. You know, it just seems to get better and better. We breed it up a little bit tonight and got some speed out of it, but I was almost on the free side, as y'all can see. I was pretty sideways, thanks to some of that old dirt track stuff, what my daddy taught me. I just want to thank Mark Gilbert, TDS, PBM, all these guys right here has helped us. First race of the year, second place. If it'd been 40 laps, it might have been a little different story. I all fell a couple anyway, you know what I mean? Congratulations to Gary. Nathan's doing a heck of a job, man. He has improved over the last 2 years, leaps and bounds. And I can see it, so everybody else here ought to be able to see that as well. We just need a few more laps. But at the same token, if I'd have made a mistake, you know what I mean? Oh, and Ronnie Plummer too.
Well, thank you so much. You did have a great battle there.
Yeah, man, it was all I could do to stay right there with him. And I tell you what, we got some of the best here. Todd Massey's won I don't know how many races here. Gary Causey dominating in this division. So just to be able to run with those guys and be up front is just incredible. So,
well, and I was about to ask you about that improvement. How's it been trying to learn the ropes and really getting that racecraft, everything that goes into it, being able to put all that together?
Mainly, it's just learning how to set these cars up to get around this place. So, like you just said, they've been running here since it was dirt. They know it in and out, upside down, backwards, it don't matter. So, it's just trying to get that catch-up game just to be there. And it looks like we're finally kind of getting to where I want to be. Hopefully, I can be on that front, you know, starting spot or finishing spot next time. So,
we'll see you doing a little bit later on this year. Great run there for Nathan. Have a great race.
They're going to wave off that start.
last lap to being hounded by one of the best in the business to do it, and Dylan Marlowe.
Yeah, it got pretty close there. You know. I was just trying to hold on to it. I knew once he got past me, it'd be hard to get back around him. I mean, I was pretty tight the whole race, really. But overall, we had a pretty good car tonight.
Yeah, it looks like it is. You are able to get it done in thrilling fashion. You're able to make it 2-for-2 tonight, though, with your dad. He won the first win.
Yeah, man, I hope that was a good race for the fans and everybody. And man, we needed a green flag run, you know, kept getting those red flags. He was able to pull himself down. I could tell he was burning his right rear up. So. And I just knew to buy my time, I could be there at the end. And I just had to push a little bit hard there. And I gave it all I could with that race, man. I know I'm going to change the goals, but I don't want to tear the race hard every weekend.
Well, and kind of talking us through, we had a lot of.
Try
and stay mentally kind of caught up
with
red flags and everything
going
there.
You know, man, just red flags, just thinking about how I can better my restarts and kind of stay closer to him. You know, with a crate motor, he's got that built motor. Restarts, he can kill me and kind of yard me, so I just got to make that time back up in a 5-10 lap run.
All right, well, Dylan
Harper,
there's a lot going on right there. You're able to find yourself in third. How's it feel?
Yeah, it feels good. I just got to thank everybody that helps us out. Universal Forest Products, UFP, Site Built, Trust Track, and all the employees that came out tonight. Burt Logistics, Tennessee Construction, Curtis Flower Farm, and my daddy, Scotty King, Greg Marlowe, and Daryl Pope.
All right, a long list of names. able to win this second win and take home a victory here for the first time in Ace Speedway late model stock competition. Well, Dustin, you thought
you had a car that if you could get out front and control it, you thought you could end up in victory lane. You just proved it right there.
Yeah, we have. I made a little small change. At first, I thought it was just the wrong way. It took a little bit to get going, but the car really come in. I'll be honest with you, we could have run mid laps if we wanted to. I could just get going. The car always set up for longer runs anyway, so these shorter races. Sometimes you got to change it up a little bit to get that quick speed, get out front. But yeah, I got to thank my guys. You know, worked hard, made a few smart right changes there. Got to thank Runley Trailers, HC Sellers, Sellers Racing, Charlie's Automotive. Got to thank Sprinkle Oil. Got to thank AAR Roofing, Lee Ball with Downforce Graphics. Man, we got it. Got a good piece. We just got to work on it and get a little better.
All right, always looking to get better even when you're in victory lane. Dustin Rumble, your winner tonight here in Twin 50s. It'll be a really solid night.
Yeah, I mean, we had a great car. Jamie done a great job holding off Dylan right there at the end. But I wish I would have left the car alone. I freed the car up a little bit, and Dustin, that's where he was getting me. He was getting that good drive up off, and I couldn't get that drive off. But I tried to do a crossover on that restart, but I backed off a little bit because it was a little too aggressive right there at the start. But congratulations, Dustin. He had a great car. And we got something to work with now, so we're there just a little fine tuning.
All right, we'll see you back out at Ace. And it's going to look a lot better running here in this second twin.
Oh, yeah, man. This car, when we unloaded today, we got done with it this morning at, like, well, this I'd say probably like lunchtime. And we got loaded up and headed here and never had any laps on it. Had 8 laps on it and we qualified second, you know, but wish it was a little bit bigger field of cars. But still some good guys in front of us right there. And we got a little bit of work to get a little bit better, but it's brand new. It's Mike Bledsoe Mechanical Machine. I got to thank Blake and Mike Bledsoe for giving me an opportunity to build them a race car, and hopefully we can get something a little bit better here and make it a little bit better, and they can have some success this year. I just got to thank the good Lord above for being able to put me in this position, all the people that he surrounds me with, and I just like Mike Bledsoe Mechanical, Digital Repair, Jim, LP Gear, just everybody that's had a part in the car, man. I appreciate it.
All right, Trevor Ward brings him home in third tonight after Dustin Rumble, Jason York, and Trevor Ward round out your top three here for late model stock car competition. And ladies and gentlemen, that is going to do it for us here at Ace Speedway. We are so happy that you decided to come out and celebrate Flag Day here at Ace Speedway with us here in the third annual Flag Day 225 presented by ALCOVETS. We want to thank ALCOVETS for all they contributed here, and of course we invite you all to contribute your time, your effort into Alamance County Veterans and ALCOVETS as well, to give your time and effort into that. It's a great cause, and of course we want to support our veterans as much as they deserve to be known. July 8th, that'll be the next time we're out here at Ace Speedway. We got pretty much every class you saw tonight, late models, limited late models, many stock and much more. Again, we want to thank you all for coming out on behalf of the Turner family and everybody out here at Ace Speedway. I'm Blake McCandless. Thank you for watching, supporting Short Track Racing. We look forward to seeing you back down here on July 8th. Please drive home safely. Thank you, and good night.